Oh shit, this is gonna be a problem. How to do a plumbing rough end. Guys, in this video, we're gonna talk about a rough end, the plumbing under your house. We're gonna talk about how it's done, why it's done, what things are for, and make sure you stay till the end because I'm gonna show you a problem I've already found that will cost this homeowner hundreds of thousands of dollars if it's not detected early. So it's a cold, sunny day here in Dallas, Texas, and I'm hanging out at the office. Just want to tell y'all, I got my hoodie on, got my sunglasses on, got my flannels on. We're going to walk a plumbing rough today. If you're a plumber, do me a favor, leave me a comment, let me know, have you ever done a rough before or no? If you're a service plumber, maybe you never have. If you're a new construction plumber, do you specialize in rough ends, top outs, or setting fixtures? We're going to put together some videos to show people how to do a little bit of all of it. If you're new to the channel or you've been here before and you haven't done it, do me a favor and subscribe and ring the bell so you don't miss out on anything. And if you like the content we're creating, leave us a comment and share it with somebody that you know that might like to learn more about getting into plumbing. So anyway, it starts right here. I'm looking at a hole about 7 or 8 feet deep. Now, I don't want to climb down in there because it's not shored off properly. It's tapered back a little bit, but you can tell the sides are already sloughing off. But this is a city tap. This is where the city gives them a connection for the plumber to actually tie onto. One thing that I do like about this is the plumber actually came up and put a clean out right out here in the front yard, right where the tap is. Now I like that because of two different reasons. Because if the main's clogged up, this whole thing's gonna be clogged up. You can try to run a snake in, you've only gotta go 12, 15 feet, nothing far, to see if you can break it up. If not, it's on the city, it's their problem. At that point, call your friends, call your neighbors, ask them, are you having problems with your drainage system? I love the fact that this plumber put a clean out right here. Now here's one thing I don't like though. The tap is 4 inch. They give you a 4 inch rise right here. They come up to the clean out is 4 inch. Right after it, they do a 4x3 reducing coupling and they reduce down and run a 3 inch yard service all the way up to the double clean out. My thought as a plumber is look, it does not cost that much more to run 4 inch, and I prefer the bigger line. If I ever built my own house, I would plumb it 4 inch almost from the very front to the very back to make sure I never have a problem. It's not my house though, I get it. These are tract homes, they're putting in a ton of them. They're trying to save every dollar they can, and I do completely get that. But when the city gives you a 4 inch tap, man, go ahead and run a 4 inch line. So right here's the 4x3 reducing coupling I was talking about. And here's the clean out, and I love this because now once the land is graded off, they'll put a female adapter right here, take the lid off, clean it out when you need to. Now this is a 3 inch test tee. They've got a test plug in here and this system's full of water. Now remember, hang around at the end and I'm gonna show you how I know they've got a problem with this house. And really, it's all because of this. Okay, so the neat thing is, this is one of my favorite things about plumbing and this should be on every house. This is a double clean out. Now there's a double clean out and there's a two-way clean out. A double clean out is two combinations put together where if you stick your camera or your sewer machine in this side, it's gonna go towards the house. Plumbers, be very careful. Homeowners, be very careful. If you run a sewer machine too far, you can bust a toilet. You can come up in a shower. You can do some crazy stuff. If you put your camera or sewer machine in this side, it's gonna go towards the main. So if your yard service is clogged up, remember, this one has a 3 inch yard service. This is gonna help unclog that. So the neat thing to me about this is when we come do a sewer water test on a house, we can actually stick a test ball in here, line it up right here between them. Y'all seen me do the videos before. Now we can fill the water up on this side up to slab level to make sure everything holds. We can look in this side and make sure no water's running past it. So to me, a double clean out is one of the smartest things. Now they do make a two-way clean out, which is a single fitting that comes up to one branch coming up. I don't like those because it's really hard to push things the direction you want them. And if you're doing a sewer water test, if you push a test ball this way, there's nowhere out here to fill it up from. If you push it this way, there's no way of knowing if anything's leaking past it. So I really do love these double cleanouts, and that's what we install most of. Now, one more thing that I like about this area, as you see right down here by this water line, is that ball valve. What I like about that, that is an isolation valve. Every homeowner should know about that. A lot of municipalities are getting where they don't want us to go out and get into the meter box. Some cities don't even want the plumber to get into the meter box, more or less the homeowner. So I love these and we recommend these all the time. If I have a valve like this, I can isolate the yard service from the house service and tell you if you have a leak on either one, or I can leave it open and test both and tell you if you have a leak under your house. Just like we do on the sewer test, we test the water. For new home buyers, they should always test a house. Now, I used to say that if the house was over 5 years old, but this is a brand new house that's actually getting inspected today. Stay till the end, because this is something you're gonna wanna see. So this line coming up, this is actually where they fill it with water to do the inspection. That's why it's painted orange, so the inspector can walk right up and look at it. I love this because the general contractor came up a while ago and actually clipped the prints on the front of the house so the inspector would be able to look at it and know exactly what he's looking at. Now this line is actually just brought up as a clean out. I'm standing inside the edge of the garage, so this line they will actually bring up 90 over and put a female adapter on it. So if there's ever a clog right here at the front of the house, you could actually run a machine in there from inside the garage. Plumbers love that. That way we don't have to protect our wheels, roll through the house, things like that. It just makes it quicker and easier, and it's a lot cleaner for the homeowner. If there's a clean out in the garage or outside, which this house has also, they're easier to do. So what I could do as a plumber is come in, open this clean out, go in, go down, and it's gonna turn due to the combination and clean all the way to the two-way clean out. If I have a long enough cable on my machine, I can always run all the way out to the main. Maybe it's cold outside and I don't want to stand out front in the wind. I can come into the garage and take care of it from here. Now remember, I told you stay till the end and you'll know why. When I came out yesterday, that water level was up around in here. Now that water level's down around in here, and we're gonna see what the problem is. The thing I want you to remember, this is why you need to do a sewer water test on any house you buy, even a brand new one. Now here's where that clean out was, but I wanted to stop and show you this. This is a water main coming in. Now, it's PEX, it's clear PEX, it's wrapped, it's insulated. The way they did, they put a valve on the outside, they ran the water line in, they've got one stub up point. Now, one thing that I would have done is I would have stubbed it up inside the edge of the garage. That way you could put another valve in there. I love having the valve outside, but I also like it on an interior wall. If there's an access panel inside the house that the customer can just open and turn a valve, you can keep them from going outside, getting wet, maybe it's raining, storming, anything like that, and they need to shut their water off because of a problem. If there's a valve in a house, it makes it so much easier to do. But I do love the fact that this is in, it's underground, it's insulated. After reaching down though, what I don't like, they didn't tape it off good, so it's not sealed properly. Could have done a better job, could have got bigger insulation. I'm feeling the way it squeezed. They've got the wrong size insulation on here and it won't hold together. Anyway, guys, buyer beware. So here we go. I know I'm at a toilet here. The reason being, I've got a 4x390. So the main comes in, it branches off and goes over to that clean out I told you about. Then you've got a combination turning up that has a 4x390 on it. So you've got a combination turning up, you've got a sand tee that comes over the 4x390. So this is actually where the toilet will sit. So I'm assuming this is a powder bath or something. With this riser, they can put a sand tee on up here, wet vent the toilet. You've got a minor over a major, wet vent the toilet and come over. Now you've got a lavatory and toilet. This is actually probably a powder bath. But the way this is roughed in, this is the way we've been doing it for years. Bring one drain up, you've got 3-inch, it goes to 2-inch, branch off, catch your lavatory, and catch your water closet right here. So now what we've got is something unique. You see this line? It's stubbed up right here, it goes down, it goes over, and comes up. Well, the way it goes up on both ends, it tells me it's not a drain or anything. What is it? Well, what this is a loop to run a water line in. This is actually, I'm gonna tell you, is probably gonna be the kitchen. The reason I say that, you can literally run your water lines down over here. If you've got an island out here, now you can put your island vent on it, you can put a Studer vent, air admittance valve, whatever you wanna put on it. But you drop your water down over here in the wall, you run your hot and cold in through here, now you've got hot and cold water all the way over here to your kitchen sink. Now the good thing is, this is probably where the ice maker goes. You branch off that, put your ice maker right there. I mean, think about it. You got a kitchen sink and cabinet here, you got a refrigerator right there, nice little kitchen here, and you get your water done under the slab. That way you're not having to run a bunch of lines overhead, come down in a side wall and run all the way down to it. It's a great way to do it. And even if you don't have that tied together, what if this was just literally an island right here? This is a great way to do it because you got your water coming down in there, you got your drain coming out here, and with an air admittance valve or an island loop, you can do that and you know everything's gonna work fine. So again, we got some more lines here. Now these probably actually go upstairs. This one could be stubbed up to catch a washer machine, washer box, anything like that. This one probably goes all the way upstairs to catch the upstairs bathrooms. So these lines, without looking at the drawing, I can't really tell you what they're for, but you can tell by looking at everything, it's primed, it's holding. They've got the conduit in helping hold things straight. I like that. This is something that plumbers have been doing for years, so we can get in, put everything in, bed it. As you see, they've got sand packed real good around everything. These lines don't move a lot. When you stand on them, they don't move at all. This is a good way to do a rough. Actually, it's the right way to do a rough. So again, now we're probably in the master bath, and I'm saying this without looking at the drawing because I've got a toilet right here. There's my 4x390. You've got the branch line coming off, which can be a vent, which could also be used to catch a lavatory, because if you notice, there's no sand tee here with the riser for the toilet. That's actually where the toilet will set. So this is the vent for it, and they could catch a lavatory off of it. Now, we've got a couple of P-traps right back here. Now the P-traps are a little bit different. That means it's either a tub or a shower. And it makes sense that this could be the master bathroom because possibly a tub and a shower both in there. They're definitely catching two fixtures like that because you can see the P-trap on both of them, and there's not really a toilet over here, so I would say that both of these are going to be for one bathroom. And then over here you've got the 3-inch clean out and riser, so that's possibly going to go upstairs just like the other one to catch any plumbing upstairs. Now this is where we had the problem. Right here, as walking around earlier shooting B-roll of just all the pipe, I stepped down and you can see my footprints. There is a leak right around in here. Not sure exactly where it is. I mean, look at this, it is wet. Now this is why inspections happen. But here's the deal, guys, me just walking around, if I would not have stepped right there, I would not have seen it because it had dry sand on top of it. Water, when it leaks, goes down. This is why it's so important for every home buyer to do a sewer water test on every house they buy. Look, I know the plumbers did not do this intentionally. This is a good rough. It looks really good. Everything looks good. Everything looks true, plumb and square, which is what every plumber wants to strive to do. What I can tell you about it though, they've definitely got a problem. This is a leak that, if it keeps going, if the sewer line ever backs up and this holds a lot of water, it can leak out a lot. You see how wet it was with me stepping there? This is brand new. 5 years from now, 2 years from now, a year from now, how much water is going to go through there? How much of this is going to leak out and erode away under the slab and cause them to have foundation problems? This is why, as a buyer, whether you're buying a new home, whether you're buying a used home, I always recommend doing a sewer water test. You don't ever want to buy a home with any leaks under it. So how to do a rough end? Guys, they did a really good job. This looks fantastic. If you're a plumber and you saw anything that I didn't see, do me a favor, leave me a comment down below. If you're a home buyer, if you're a homeowner, did you do a sewer water test under your house? And does this explanation help you figure things out a little bit easier? I'm Roger Wakefield, Lead AP, the expert plumber. And from a cold day in Dallas, I'll see you in the next video if you don't get